नमस्कार मित्रों, बहुत बहुत स्वागत है हमारे YouTube चैनल पर जिसका नाम है PV एजुकेशन हॉल्ट। और यहाँ पर आपको मिलती हैं शॉर्ट एंड डिक्टेशंस, आउटलाइंस और फ्रेजेस। दोस्तों, अगर अभी आप नए हैं हमारे चैनल पर और अभी तक आपने चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब जरूर कर लें, साथ ही बेल आइकन को जरूर दबाएँ ताकि आपको नोटिफिकेशंस मिलते रहें। क्योंकि बेल आइकन को दबाने से ही आपके पास हमारे डिक्टेशन का कोई भी जो नया डिक्टेशन हम डालेंगे उसका नोटिफिकेशन आपके पास सबसे पहले पहुँचेगा। साथ ही आप हमारे फेसबुक चैनल, फेसबुक जो हमारा एक ग्रुप है उससे भी जुड़ सकते हैं, साथ में टेलीग्राम चैनल से जुड़ सकते हैं। उन सभी के लिंक्स आपको डिस्क्रिप्शन में मिल जाएंगे। साथ ही ये जो आज डिक्टेशन बोलने जा रहे हैं जिसकी स्पीड रहेगी 80 वर्ड पर मिनट और आज की हमारी पहली डिक्टेशन है, इसका आप मैटर भी PDF से ले सकते हैं। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। 5 सेकेंड्स। द 7th प्लान represents a conscious, internally consistent and carefully thought out program for the most efficient exploitation of our resources possible in existing conditions. The basic aim is to raise the standard of living of the people, especially of the less privileged sections of society. Our planning should result not only in an integrated process of increased production, but rational distribution of the added wealth. The overriding inspiration must be a burning sense of social justice. While increased production is of the utmost importance, it is equally important to remove or reduce and prevent the concentration of wealth and economic power. The benefits of development should accrue in increasing measure to the common man and the weaker sections of society, so that the forces of production can be fully unleashed. A sense of involvement or participation by the people as a whole is vital for the success of any plan of rapid economic growth. This can only be evoked by securing social justice, by reducing disparities of income and wealth, and by redressing regional imbalances. Our orientation of our socio-economic institutions in this spirit is, accordingly, the first necessity. Para. 1 year of this plan has already gone by. Between the draft plan and the present document, certain important changes have been made. The projected investment in the public sector has been stepped up so as to enable us to undertake a larger and bolder agenda of work. New schemes have been added to help the small farmer throughout the country, especially in the unirrigated areas. The emphasis is squarely on areas that have hitherto suffered from neglect of transport and housing problems in urban regions will receive more attention. A small but significant beginning is also being made with special programs for children. The 7th plan provided a necessary corrective to the earlier trend, which helped particularly the stronger sections in agriculture as well as in industry to enable them rapidly to enlarge and diversify the production base. In the long run, the full potential of growth cannot be realized unless the energies of all our people are put to profitable use. The emphasis on spreading the impetus and benefits of economic growth to the weaker sections is thus necessary in the interest of equality as well as growth. The plan will now assist the less prosperous sections of our farming population to improve their position and make a yet bigger contribution to the national economy. Greater industrial activity and the modernization of agriculture by adopting intensive methods of cultivation and irrigation would mean that a larger proportion of young men seeking jobs could find employment nearer home. Full stop. Thank you.